Today, in Form 12th Economics, Chapter Number 3, Liberalization, Privatization, Globalization, it is the 19th frame. So, in this 19th frame, we will analyze or we will do the critical analysis of the major aspects of the Indian economy with reference to the reforms of 1991, rather to say the LPG reforms of 1991. So these are some important aspects like growth and employment, number 2 agriculture, number 3 industries, number 4 disinvestment, and lastly the fiscal policy or budgetary policy of India. So we'll start with the first point, that is the growth and employment. See, that time in the 1991, with the imposition of some sanctions and conditions, our market, Indian market, was open for the MNCs. And the MNCs, multinational corporations, they were looking for the new markets along the world. Because they have come to the saturation and there was a fierce competition among the firms and companies in the developed countries. So mostly the MNCs from the developing country, they want market expansion and search of new markets, especially in India, because India has the middle class income group, which is the largest part of the society, and this Indian middle class income group attracted the MNCs to a lot. And MNCs have assured our that time government, that time finance minister were Mr. Manmohan Singh, and the Prime Minister was P.V. Narasimha Rao. So they have assured, they have given them assurance that they will create lot of jobs for the Indians. So what was the thing, but what reality was something different. There were some contradictory. Our GDP growth rate increased with commencement of the liberalization and globalization and privatization, but as compared to the GDP, we were not able to increase the job opportunities and the chances for the employment for the Indian youth, is rather to say the Indian educated youth. So in the first point, it was proven fact that GDP growth rate increased with 1991 LPG reforms, liberalization, privatization and globalization reforms. This led rise in the output and income. GDP increases means there is increase in the output and income. But it could not create much opportunities for the job and employment for the Indian youth. So it was a contradiction that GDP is growing, but the job opportunities, they were not growing in the expected manner. The problem of unemployment remained as it was. Okay, so this growth, GDP growth rate was there, but as far as the opportunities of employment, we could not create the much opportunities. The second is agriculture. See, the agriculture has been the backbone of the primary sector, especially of India, because around 70% population still reside in the villages and the rural areas, and they are mainly engaged in the agriculture and related activities. But after the reforms, it has been seen that there was continuous decline in the agriculture production, and agriculture sector faced a lot of challenges and problems. So we will discuss what were the reasons for that, what were the main reasons for the decline in the agriculture sector. So second aspect, that is decline in agriculture. The agriculture sector, was which represents the primary sector in India, could not do well in the post reform period, means after 1991 it could not do well. Even in the 2014-15, the growth rate in the agriculture sector was in a negative. It was only minus 0.2% in the 2014 and 15. So the growth rate of the agriculture was negative minus 0.2%. So what were the main reasons behind this? Although some of the reason they were led, they have been given by the imposition of the sanctions and conditions imposed on India by the World Bank and IMF for giving the loan to India so that we can revive our economy. So some of the main reasons I will discuss here, that reduction in government expenditure. The government has reduced its investment and expenditure, especially the infrastructure development that is very much required for the agriculture, like dams, irrigation facilities, forward market linkage, warehouses, storage, transportation, roads. So government has reduced its expenditure. So it has adversely affected the whole agriculture sector. So the reduction in government expenditure, especially in the development of agriculture infrastructure like irrigation, dams, roads, market linkage, power, research and development. So they have given a hit to the agriculture, and there was a decline in the agriculture productivity. Point B, removal of subsidy. The subsidy on the fertilizers, on the urea and tractor and other instruments and tools, which is very much useful, especially for the small or marginal farmers, that had been reduced or removed. So the removal of subsidy also put a pressure on the financial condition of the farmers. So it was also a demotivating factor. So the removal of subsidy, the subsidy on the fertilizers and agricultural instruments, this agri is the short form, it is agricultural instrument, was withdrawn by the government, which adversely affected the small and marginal farmer. Even the rich farmer, they have not been affected to a great extent, but as far as the small farmers with very small size of land and the marginal farmers, they have been affected adversely by this removal of the subsidy. Point C, reduction of tariffs and non-tariff barriers. This is with the international trade. With the commencement of the liberalization and privatization, globalization, and the sanctions from the IMF and World Bank, we have to open our market with removal of the tariffs and removal of the quotas. The tariffs have been reduced to a great extent. So now the import of agriculture is very much easy for the businessmen, because they are able to import more agri products, but it affected badly or hit badly to our domestic farmers, because they are not able to compete with the less expensive or cheap imports of agriculture. So reduction of the tariff and non-tariff barriers, with the new conditions imposed by the World Bank and IMF, the import duties on agriculture products were reduced to a great extent and quotas have been eliminated. This resulted in rise of imports of agriculture products from developed nation. Point D, the removal of MSP. It is the minimum support price, which just like an insurance from the government side, that at this price, if the buyers are not able to buy, then government will purchase the agriculture output. So it was an assurance and insurance for the farmers by the government, but it has also been withdrawn. Shifting from food grain to cash crops is the last point. With the new export oriented policies after the reforms, most of the farmers shifted the production of food grain to the cash crops like tea, coffee, jute, cotton, sugarcane, oil seeds, etc. So this also increased the price of the rice and wheat, because they were the food grain. So this way, the shift of the production from food grain to the cash crop also affected our agriculture sector badly. So these are some of the reasons.